Filmmakers and DOPs are looking for perfect, smooth and fluid zooms. To achieve this, you will need the Chrosziel Zoomer. My name is Tim Stehmann from Chrosziel, and today we're going to talk about the Chrosziel Zoomer and how to set it up with the Sony FX9, the Sony FX6, or on general. So let's deep dive into the Sony FX9. The zoom has a 15 millimeter rod clamp, so wherever you have 50 millimeter rods, you can mount it to any zoom you want to use. So what you do is you simply slide it on, mount it to the lens and tighten it. Then what you need is a power cable. For that power cable, you simply mount this to the zoomer and then place it here in the back onto your D-tab power source. As soon as you have done that, the motor will start immediately, will calibrate itself, and will be ready to go. How to control it? What you do is you can control it by the zoom rocker of the Sony FX9. So you unmount the hand grip, put our little adapter in between, slide this into the camera, and put the jack into the motor. Power on your camera, and as soon as the camera has started, you are able to zoom in and out via your zoom rocker and how you're used to work with standard zooms. Let's have a look on how you would do the same setup on the Sony FX6. For the Sony FX6, we chose a photo zoom lens, the Sony G Master series. And for that lens, you have a manual zoom and there's no zoom motor built in, and you don't have the 0.8 pitch of the standard cine gears. So what you do is, in the box, we have this little flexi gear and you mount it onto the lens and tighten it. And then when we slide on the motor on this side, you will see it will not be easy to fit to it with that short lens, and you can easily just turn that motor around and then slide it in from that side. And then before I mount it completely, I really quick put the power cable onto that motor because it's more easy to do it this way, real quick, and then slide it onto the gear. And all we have to do now is give it power here on the back. As soon as we have given power to it, you see it starts auto-calibrating. And now what we have to do is we have to get the zoom rocker command from the smart grip with the jack connection. So that cable is inside the box as well. So use this one, which is labeled for the Sony FX6 camera. This goes in here, and then the other side goes into the zoom servo drive. All you need to do now is power on your camera. As soon as it's powered on, you are able to zoom in and out with various speeds on the zoom rocker. While we are talking about using the zoom rocker of the FX6, how about other cameras? If you're using the Sony FS5 or FS7 camera, you simply can use their zoom rockers on the smart grips. On any other camera, you can use a standard zoom rocker based on LANC protocol. We have here the Liebeck one mounted to a hand grip. This way you can have it here in the front on your shoulder rig, or you can mount it onto your tripod handle and have the zoom while panning or tilting the camera. What you do is you disconnect the cable, connect the LANC cable to the device, and as soon as you have done that, you see you can zoom in and out while using the zoom rocker. So let's have a look at how you can power the device. So in the box, you have that D-tab power cables, but we are offering various other versions for your convenience. As an example, if you're in the Sony world, you can get a high rosy 4-pin power cable, and this way you can use accessories from the Sony or use a Sony F55 as an example to power your camera. If you're in the RE world, we are offering a 3-pin Fisher cable, an RS cable. This way you are able to power it with a 3-pin Fisher from your breakout box or even from the RE Alexa or RE Amira camera. For the Alexa Mini, we are offering a 1B connector, so this way you can power and start stop the camera right away with that cable. And if you do not like the angled version of the cable, we are offering a straight version. And with that straight version, you are able to run that cable in a different way. It all depends on your camera setup, but we have you covered on the variety of that. When you have powered the camera, you might want to look at various zoom options and how the motor behaves to your control. For the photo lens, we have a specific photo mode. The reason is because that lens is mostly very stiff and very unevenly running. So we have a photo mode which runs that motor very smoothly. If you have a perfect lens like the Zeiss compact zoom, which runs very fluidly, we are offering even more zoom modes. So zoom mode 1, as an example, is a documentary ENG style mode, which ramps very nicely up and down when it comes to end stop. So you always have a nice zoom when you zoom in and zoom out without stopping accidentally at the end stops. For sound applications where you have to have very quiet state and you don't want to have any noise, we offer a zoom mode 2. Zoom mode 2 is a silent mode where we limit the top speed of the motor, and this way we don't hear that motor at all. For ENG and broadcasts and live operations, we are offering zoom mode 3, which has very fast zoomer in and out, so you can zoom in real quick, pull focus, zoom back out, and continue to shoot. And then we have the zoom mode 4, which is a direct raw mode, so we don't do anything with your commands. There's no ramping up and down, nothing in between, direct control. To switch between those different zoom modes, you simply use your zoom rocker. So by pressing down more than 10 seconds, you will switch to the next zoom mode. If you have a motor like the Sony FX6 setup, and where you want to turn it around, that motor, you need to change the zoom direction. So by pressing on the wide side more than 10 seconds, you are changing the motor direction. So this way you have the reverse direction in regards to the zoom rocker. For any questions you have about the setup, please visit our website chrosziel.com or drop us an email at info@chrosziel.com. Thank you.